This is a cast saw. It's used to extract you from a cast after your bones have healed. The blades are sharp enough and fast enough to cut through the hard outer shell of the cast. And that seems pretty dangerous given how close the cutting blade gets to soft human skin parts. And it would be a terrible idea for someone with no medical experience to attempt such a procedure on themselves. Like, what if my hand slipped and the blade touched my skin? Well, it turns out nothing would happen, actually, because a cast saw is able to cut through a cast, but it's not able to cut through human skin. To see how that's possible, we need to film it in slow motion. My first thought was that because the movement is cyclic, I could use the stroboscopic effect to fake having a high-speed camera, like I did in my gravitational waves video. If you want an explanation of how the stroboscopic effect works, watch to the end of that video, link in the card and the description. But when I actually tried that, the rolling shutter artifacts were just off the charts. So I hired a phantom high-speed camera that can do 2000 frames per second in full HD. Straight away, you can see that the blade isn't in fact spinning. It's oscillating backwards and forwards. And looking at the footage, it's only moving back and forth about 3 millimeters. A tiny distance, really. Actually, you don't need a high-speed camera to show that. If I draw a mark on the blade and turn it on, you can see the mark doesn't spin round. It becomes blurry around the edges, which tells us that it's oscillating, not spinning. We'll get to the slow motion footage of the blade on my skin in a moment. But first, here's a clue as to why a cast saw can cut through a cast, but not through human skin. Here's an underinflated balloon, and here's an overinflated balloon. The cast saw can't pop the underinflated balloon. But look what happens when I press it into the overinflated balloon. It pops easily. The difference is, when you overinflate a balloon, you're pushing the balloon to its elastic deformation limit. It can't stretch anymore after that. So when the teeth of the blade touches the rubber can't stretch and move underneath it. The blade scrapes along the rubber, which cuts a hole through it. The underinflated balloon has a lot of stretch still left in it. The rubber just moves and stretches underneath the teeth, so no hole can be cut. And it turns out that human skin is like an underinflated balloon. You can see that really clearly here. As the teeth bite into my skin, they proceed to just casually move the skin back and forth. It's fun to see the ripples propagate outwards from the point of contact there. This is probably a good opportunity to point out that although you may have a tool at home that is superficially similar to a cast saw, it may very well operate in a different way. For example, it may be a rotary tool as opposed to an oscillating tool. This Dremel is a rotating tool, and look what it does to the underinflated balloon. The rubber can only stretch so far. Hopefully I got that warning out before anyone paused the video to run and get their angle grinder. Even if you know for sure that the tool you're holding is an oscillating tool, it may be that the distance over which it oscillates could be beyond the elastic deformation limit of your skin. In other words, it could cut you. And in fact, if the tool was sharp enough, it could cut you anyway. What I'm saying is, don't try this at home. I wonder about hairs. I wonder if I could use a cast saw to shave. Before we find out, it's interesting to see in slow motion how the cast saw interacts with the different types of cast you can get. The traditional cast is made from plaster of Paris. So first you put on this sleeve, then you wrap your arm in padding. I mean, you don't do it, the doctor does. The roll of fabric, which has all this plaster of Paris powder on it, is dipped in water. That's then wrapped around your arm, and it dries fully in 24 to 48 hours. Which is quite a long time to wait, but it's really cool to see plaster of Paris being cut in slow motion. Because it's rigid, the teeth of the saw scrape along the surface of the cast, chipping away little bits of it that you can see flying through the air. Another cool thing I noticed is the oscillating blade actually moves the whole cast back and forth a little bit. But look, the plaster of Paris shavings kind of float above the surface while the cast jiggles about underneath. So that's a plaster of Paris cast, but if you broke your arm today, they would most likely put on a synthetic cast like this. I mean, they wouldn't put it on like this. The fabric is fiberglass and it's coated in a water-activated resin. So the process starts in the same way. You dip the roll in water, but once it's applied to the arm, it only takes about 15 minutes to dry. And actually, it creates much less mess when you're cutting it off. Something interesting about the waves that radiate out from the contact point, they represent the speed of sound of my skin. It's interesting to see how the speed of sound is different on different parts of my arm. Here on the back of my arm, I estimate it's about 10 meters per second, but on the back of my hand, it's about 6 meters per second. Interestingly, from that, I can calculate the shear modulus of my skin, and from that, I can calculate the Young's modulus of my skin. But to get from the shear modulus to Young's modulus, I need to know what the Poisson ratio of my skin is. I talked about the Poisson ratio in my auxetics video, link in the card in the description. When I googled Poisson number of skin, I got this result. The Poisson ratio of cow teat skin was measured uni and biaxially and is shown to be anisotropic and dependent on aspect ratio. So there you go. But I also found out that the Poisson ratio of human skin is about 0.48. And it turns out that the Young's modulus for the back of my hand is about 100 kilopascals, and the Young's modulus for the back of my arm is about 300 kilopascals. Which is good to know. I really don't like vendor lock-in. For example, email doesn't have vendor lock-in. Like, I could use Gmail as my vendor, you could use Hotmail, and we could still communicate with each other. Whereas I couldn't use Facebook to DM you on Twitter because those services use proprietary protocols that don't talk to each other. It even happens in the physical world. Like, I have this power tool and a bunch of batteries that go with the power tool, but the connection is proprietary, so if I wanted to switch to a different brand of power tool, I'd need to buy a bunch of new batteries to go with it. Even razors have proprietary connection technology, so once you've bought a particular razor handle, you have to continue buying the cartridges from the same manufacturer. But of course, there's been an open standard for razor blades for over 200 years, the safety razor. Why would you buy into a proprietary standard when you could get a beautifully engineered safety razor from the sponsor of this video, Henson Shaving, and then buy quality blades from whoever you like for pennies? Compare that to a cartridge razor where the handle is cheap but the cartridges are sold at a huge markup. It might seem like an economical option at the beginning, but it's a false economy. The total cost of ownership of the Henson AR-13 is lower than a cartridge razor after just a few months. The Henson AR-13 is what you get when a family-run aerospace machine shop pivots to making their own products. The blade is well supported by its all-metal body. It protrudes exactly 30 microns from the plane at an angle of tau on 12 radians for a really nice shave. The nice thing is you only have to buy a new handle once a year. Wait, once a lifetime. It's something you literally buy once ever. But what's the actual shave like? Well, I shaved this side of my face with the Henson AR-13, and I shaved this side of my face with a cast saw, and the difference is unbelievable. Go to hensonshaving.com/Steve Mould and use promo code Steve Mould at checkout to get 100 free blades with your purchase of a razor. Just make sure both items are in the basket when you apply the code. The link is also in the description, so check out Henson Shaving today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit subscribe, and the algorithm thinks you'll enjoy this video next.